In the previous class, we discuss about the muscles of the extensor and flexor present in the forearm region, forearm and manus region. So name these muscles. The extensor muscles of the forearm and manus region. Name the extensor muscles of forearm and manus region.
Extensor carpi radialis, extensor carpi obliquus, common digital extensor, medial digital extensor, and lateral digital extensor.
Okay, extensor carpi radialis, extensor carpi obliquus, medial digital extensor, common digital extensor, lateral digital extensor. These are the muscles of the extensor area of forearm and manus region. These muscles situated at which aspect?
Anterior medial aspect of forearm and manus region.
Anterior medial aspect. Aur kuch correction karo bhai.
Anterior lateral aspect.
Anterior lateral aspect. And flexor muscles?
Posterior medial.
Posterior medial. Name the flexor muscles. Name the flexor muscles.
Flexor carpi radialis, flexor carpi ulnaris, superficial digital flexor, deep digital flexor, ulnaris lateralis. Pronator teres.
Pronator teres. So these muscles we will encounter towards the flexor side. We discuss about the muscles of extensor region, origin and insertion of extensor and flexor muscles. We already discussed. Now we will continue with the blood supply of the forearm, brachiocephalic trunk. How the brachiocephalic trunk originate? What is brachiocephalic trunk? Cranial aorta को बोलते हैं brachiocephalic trunk. कैसे originate होता है इसके बारे में कुछ पता है? क्या है, कैसे है? Do you guys know about the blood supply to the head region? How the blood supply to head region occur?
Via carotid artery.
Via carotid artery. And carotid artery come from the carotid artery come from the how the carotid artery originate?
Ma'am, bicarotid trunk.
Bicarotid trunk. And bicarotid trunk from where bicarotid trunk come?
From axillary artery.
From axillary artery? No. No, from the subclavian artery. Do you guys aware with the brachiocephalic trunk? ब्रेकियोसेफेलिक ट्रंक समझते हो क्या होता है? ब्रेकियोसेफेलिक ट्रंक
यस मैम, इट इज आल्सो नोन एज एंटीरियर एरोटा.
एंटीरियर एरोटा एंड हाउ द ब्रेकियोसेफेलिक ट्रंक इज ब्रांच्ड?
मैम,
इट इज नेम्ड ब्रेकियोसेफेलिक.
बाइफर्केशन ऑफ एरोटा?
नहीं, व्हाई इट इज नोन एज ब्रेकियोसेफेलिकस?
Ma'am, it is also blood brachial part and cephalic part.
It has two part, brachial part and cephalic part. Which part is brachial part and which part is cephalic part?
Ma'am, lymph region is brachial part and cephalic is head region.
Okay, then blood supply to head region is?
Carotid artery.
And blood supply to lymph?
Brachial artery.
Direct brachial artery? Then what about breath, axillary and subclavian? What about axillary and subclavian? Axillary or subclavian kya hai?
Then axillary artery supply to forelimb.
And subclavian artery? Subclavian artery kya hoti hai? When you read about the heart, एक्सटेंसर और फ्लेक्सर समझ में आ गई ना? फोरआर्म और मेनिस रीजन. व्हाट इज द टोपोग्राफिकल पोजीशन ऑफ हार्ट?
अपोजिट टू सिक्स्थ कॉन्डोस्टर्नल जॉइंट.
सो वन आयोटा इज ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द विच चैम्बर ऑफ हार्ट? Aorta is originate from which chamber of heart?
Left ventricle.
Left ventricle. Okay. So this portion is known as ascending aorta, arch of aorta, and here you will find descending aorta and origin of brachiocephalic. Brachiocephalic trunk. ठीक है, brachiocephalic trunk, and this brachiocephalic trunk give branches.
These branches within the thoracic cavity known as subclavian artery. The position of right subclavian artery and left subclavian artery is variable. The right subclavian artery originates at the level of first rib, while left subclavian artery originates at the level of second rib. Okay. So, left subclavian artery originates first and then the right subclavian artery originates. Clear? First one originates at the level of second rib and right subclavian artery originates at the level of first rib. Itna clear hai? Okay. And when this subclavian artery come outside the thoracic cavity, reaches at the medial aspect of the forelimb, at that place it known as axillary artery. What is known? Axillary artery. In book you may find intrathoracic part of axillary artery and extrathoracic part of axillary artery. ठीक है? So in book you may find intrathoracic part of axillary artery and extrathoracic part of axillary artery. However, the intrathoracic part is known as subclavian artery and extrathoracic part known as axillary artery. And after the origin of subclavian artery, right and left subclavian artery, the common trunk is known as bicarotid trunk. Okay? It named brachius pellicus because it supplies to the this forearm forelimb, and cephalic because it's supplied to the head. The brachio part is supplied by the subclavian artery and cephalic part is supplied by the carotid trunk. Clear? So the subclavian artery originates at different level from the brachiocephalic trunk. In case of dog, you may encounter the origin of the left subclavian artery from directly from the aorta, while the right subclavian artery originates from the brachiocephalic trunk. One subclavian artery originates from the brachiocephalic trunk and another one is directly originate from the aorta. When we discuss about the canine, that time we will discuss which branches originate from the brachiocephalic trunk and which branches originate directly from the aorta. But in case of cattle, both these arteries originate from the brachiocephalic trunk. Itna clear hai?
Yes, ma'am.
First, we will discuss about the intrathoracic part of the axillary artery or subclavian artery. ऊपर हमें वर्टिब्रे मिलेंगे, नीचे हमें रिब्स मिलेंगे. ये जानना इसलिए जरूरी है क्योंकि अभी हम इसकी ब्रांचिंग अब पढ़ रहे हैं. सो विद इन द थोरेसिक कैविटी द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी गिव्स द फर्स्ट ब्रांच दैट इज द वर्टिब्रल आर्टरी. फर्स्ट वन इज वर्टिब्रल आर्टरी. This branch runs in a craniodorsally muscles are present known as cranius and lumbus pulli. So this branch runs cranio dorsally in between the cranius and lumbus pulli, and this supply to this vertebral region. So this branch is known as vertebral artery. It extends from the sixth vertebrae to the first cervical vertebrae. It extends in a forward direction and it continues in the cranial cavity as the basilar artery. Have you heard about, have you read about the blood supply to the brain?
Yes, ma'am.
How the blood supply to brain occur?
Through circle of Willis.
Circle of Willis. And how the circle of Willis is formed? How the circle of Willis is formed? How the circle of Willis is formed? Different branches come together to form the circle of Willis. Huh? The cerebral artery, cerebellar artery, and these artery originate from the maxillary artery. The branches of maxillary artery from the basilar artery. ऐसा कुछ पढ़ा है कि नहीं पढ़ा है? How the rete cerebellum of Willis is formed? How the rete cerebrae mirabilis is formed? Have you heard about this term? How it is formed? कौन कौन सी branches हैं जो rete cerebrae mirabilis बनाएंगे? ये सब पढ़ चुके हो. आई जस्ट रिवाइज यू. सो यू ड्यूरिंग दिस ब्लड सप्लाई टू द ब्रेन यू विल एनकाउंटर विद द बेसिलर आर्टरी एंड देन बेसिलर आर्टरी इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ दिस वर्टिब्रल आर्टरी व्हिच ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द इंट्राथोरेसिक पार्ट ऑफ द एक्सिलरी आर्टरी और व्हिच इज द ब्रांच ऑफ द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी. ठीक है. सो फर्स्ट ब्रांच ऑफ द इंट्राथोरेसिक पार्ट इज वर्टिब्रल आर्टरी. सेकेंड ब्रांच इज posto cervical trunk. The next part is posto cervical trunk, which further divided into dorsal intercostal artery and deep cervical artery. Posterior cervical trunk, which further divided into dorsal intercostal artery and deep cervical artery. The dorsal intercostal supply to the first three intercostal space. Since the subclavian artery originate at the level of the fourth intercostal space, so it supply to the first three intercostal space, and it named as dorsal intercostal artery. Remaining pair. Remaining intercostal space is supplied by the batao bhai. Bolo. ऐसे कैसे काम चलेगा? रिमेनिंग इंटरकोस्टल इज सप्लाइड बाय द थोरेसिक एओर्टा. पढ़ चुके हो ना?
थोरेसिक एओर्टा पढ़ा है कि नहीं पढ़ा है? ब्लड सप्लाई बाय द थोरेसिक एओर्टा
पढ़ा है मैम।
उसकी क्या ब्रांचेस होती है? उसमें कहीं आती है इंटरकोस्टल आर्टरीज?
यस मैम, डॉर्सल इंटरकोस्टल आर्टरी
आती है ना वहां भी? ठीक है, सो the costo cervical trunk gives a branch dorsal intercostal artery that supply to the first three intercostal spaces and deep cervical artery. The deep cervical artery is further rib branches to the thoracic pericardial and mediastinal. Deep cervical is also supplied to the thoracic, pericardial and it runs towards the cervical area. Okay, the costo cervical trunk gives two main branches, dorsal intercostal and deep cervical, and dorsal intercostal supply to the first three intercostal spaces. Third branch is internal thoracic artery. Internal thoracic artery. This internal thoracic artery runs ventrally and it curves in the mediastinum space to supply the sternum. In this area you will find the sternum, so this blood vessel supply to the sternum and it give branches. Internal thoracic artery gives branches, that is cranial epigastric artery musculocranial artery and ventral intercostal artery. The ventral intercostal artery is applied to the ventral part of the intercostal for the
diaphragm.
So diaphragm is supplied by the branch from the internal thoracic artery that known as musculocranial artery. Epigastric, gastric term is used for the
stomach.
And stomach is situated in the कौन सी कैविटी में होता है?
Abdominal.
So, stomach is situated in the cranial part of the abdominal cavity. So, this blood vessel supply to the cranial skin region of abdominal cavity. Cranial epigastric, it supply to the cranial part of the skin of the abdominal cavity. Clear? The next branch is superficial cervical artery. Superficial cervical artery. Muscular branch. Deltoid branch. Since it runs in the superficial part of the cervical area, so
So it supply to the muscles of superficial region of the cervical area, deltoid branch, and area of the scapula as a pre-scapular artery. So this is about the intrathoracic part of the axillary artery, or this is about the course of the subclavian artery within the thoracic cavity. And as soon as it detaches these branches, this blood vessel is continuing in the axillary area as the axillary artery. So this blood vessel comes in the axillary region, it continues in the axillary artery. इसमें किसी को कोई डाउट, कोई दिक्कत, परेशानी?
ओके, सो दैट्स अबाउट द इंट्राथोरेसिक पार्ट ऑफ द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी, एंड एज सून एज इट रीचेज इनटू द एक्सिलरी रीजन, इट नेम्ड एज एक्सिलरी आर्टरी. हियर यू कैन सी द प्रेजेंस ऑफ axillary artery. The main trunk will be visualized as a axillary artery. Okay, this subclavian artery gives the branches in the area of scapula. This axillary artery gives the branches in the area of scapula, and then it descend down. And the now the main trunk is known as brachial artery. The name of the main trunk get changed according to the region as well as after the origin of a particular branch. Okay, so the subclavian artery is within the thoracic cavity, and as soon as it reaches to the outside the thoracic cavity and the axillary area in the axillary region, that time it's named as axillary artery. And as soon as it provide branches to the scapular region and continue in the area of the humerus, the main trunk is named as brachial artery. This one is axillary artery, and it gives the branches in the subscapular in the scapular region, and now it continues as a brachial artery. Clear? And after giving a branch and in the area of the radius and ulna, the main trunk is continue as a median artery. Main trunk is continue as a median artery. Clear? Okay, so now we will see the branches which provided by this blood vessel. So axillary artery give the branch, that is the external thoracic artery. Here you can see the first branch, that is the external thoracic artery, and it supply to the pectoral region as well as biceps brachii and brachiocephalicus muscle. External thoracic artery supply to the muscles of the thoracic area. Since the in the ventral aspect you will find the brachiocephalicus muscle, pectoral muscle. So this blood vessel supply to the pectoral muscle and brachiocephalicus. क्योंकि जो blood vessel है वो ventral aspect से enter करती है in the axillary area. और ventral aspect में हमें shoulder girdle की कौन सी muscles मिलेंगी? Brachiocephalicus and pectoral. That's why external thoracic blood vessel supply to the pectoral muscle, brachiocephalicus. Clear? Then it gives the suprascapular artery, and you can see that suprascapular artery runs on the cranial aspect of the scapula. Suprascapular, as its name clearly defined, it supply to the supraspinatus muscle and subscapularis muscle. Then the main branch to the subscapular muscle is subscapularis muscle, artery, subscapular artery. The main branch to the subscapularis muscle is subscapular artery. This subscapular artery divided into two branches. Here you can see the division 1 and 2. Okay. Thoracodorsal artery or dorsal thoracic artery. It named as either thoracodorsal artery or dorsal thoracic artery. And circumflex artery. Circumflex scapular artery and caudal circumflex humeral artery. Yes. First one is dorsal thoracic artery, second one is caudal circumflex scapular artery, and third one is caudal circumflex humeral artery. Clear? So as soon as axillary artery enters in the axillary region, it gives branch, that is the external thoracic artery. Then it gives another branch, that is the suprascapular artery, and third branch is subscapular artery. Suprascapular supply to the supraspinatus, external thoracic artery supply to the muscles of pectoralis muscle and brachiocephalicus muscle. Okay, so circumflex humeral artery, caudal circumflex humeral artery, dorsal thoracic artery and circumflex scapular artery, all these three branches originate from the subscapular artery. Clear? After the origin of the subscapular artery, the main trunk is continued as a brachial artery. Clear? This brachial artery is further gives various branches. This brachial artery further gives various branches. It included, first one is cranial circumflex humeral artery. The blood vessel which enters on the caudal aspect of the humerus, that is the caudal circumflex humeral artery, that is the branch of the subscapular artery, while the cranial circumflex humeral artery is the branch of brachial artery. Cranial circumflex humeral artery is the branch of brachial artery. It supply to the muscles situated in the anterior aspect of the arm area. Kaun si muscle milengi anterior aspect mein?
Brachialis and bicep brachii.
बाइसेप ब्रेकाई, ओके? और उसके अलावा और कोई मसल जो शोल्डर रीजन की नीचे तक आती हो?
ब्रेकियोसेफेलिकस.
शोल्डर रीजन की? शोल्डर रीजन की कौन सी मसल आएगी? ब्रेकियोसेफेलिकस शोल्डर गर्डल की मसल है, शोल्डर रीजन की मसल पूछ रही हूँ मैं. कोई और मसल जो बाइसेप ब्रेकाई के पास में हो?
टीरस माइनर.
कौन सी?
टीरस माइनर.
बाइसेप ब्रेकाई के पास में कौन सी मसल मिलेगी भाई? गड़बड़ कर रहे हो. कोरेको ब्रेकियलिस नहीं आएगी? मसल्स का अभी एक वीडियो हम लोग देखेंगे कई. एंड कोरेको ब्रेकियलिस मसल. द सेकेंड ब्रांच इज डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी. सेकेंड ब्रांच इज डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी एंड डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी रन्स ऑन द कॉडल एस्पेक्ट. ठीक है, एक ब्रांच आगे आई, एक ब्रांच पीछे गई. ठीक है. सो डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट में कौन सी मसल मिलेगी? पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट में कौन सी मसल्स मिलेंगी?
ट्राइसेप्स.
ट्राइसेप्स, ठीक है ना. सो डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट में है तो पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट को सप्लाई करेगी. ठीक. सो डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी सप्लाई टू द ट्राइसेप्स एंड इट फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू मस्कुलर ब्रांच एंड कोलेटरल रेडियल आर्टरी, बट इट सप्लाई टू द मेनली ट्राइसिपिटल मास. जितना भी अवेलेबल है यहाँ पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट में उसको सप्लाई करेगी डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी. ठीक है. देन another important branch is transverse cubital artery. Transverse cubital artery is runs in a anterior aspect. पहले cranial circumflex humeral आगे की तरफ आई, फिर पीछे की तरफ हमें एक branch मिलेगी deep brachial artery, और फिर again आगे की तरफ एक branch मिलेगी that is the transverse cubital artery just above the elbow joint. ठीक है, elbow joint के ऊपर की ऊपर हम देखेंगे तो हमें आगे की तरफ एक branch मिलेगी that is the transverse cubital artery. The transverse cubital artery runs on the cranial aspect and this is further divided into branches. Different branches which supply to the muscles of that particular area. Transverse cubital artery. Okay. Another important artery is collateral ulnar artery. Collateral ulnar artery, it runs on the posterior aspect of the forearm and it reaches towards the olecranon process. Collateral ulnar artery, along with the collateral ulnar artery one more branch is come, that is the common interosseous artery. Common interosseous artery. After the origin of common interosseous artery at the level of the proximal interosseous space, the main trunk is known as median artery. After the origin of the common interosseous artery at the level of the proximal interosseous space, the main trunk is known as median artery. And this common interosseous artery take part in the formation of the anterior carpal rete, posterior carpal rete, and also gives a branch that is the cranial interosseous artery. This common interosseous artery give branches to the anterior carpal rete, posterior carpal rete, and a branch that is the cranial interosseous artery, and it continues as a caudal interosseous artery. इतना समझ में आया? इतना पोर्शन क्लियर हुआ?
मैम एक बार कॉमन कैरोटिड इंट्रोसियस आर्टरी से दोबारा बता दीजिए.
हाँ. As soon as it detaches collateral ulnar artery at the same level, at the level of proximal interosseous space, the brachial artery gives branch that known as common interosseous artery. This common interosseous artery branches. ठीक है. Carpal region में क्या होता है? कार्पल बोन्स कैसे अरेंज्ड हैं? रेडियल, इंटरमीडिएट, अल्नार, एसेसरी, सेकंड प्लस थर्ड फ्यूज एंड फोर्थ कार्पल बोन्स है. एक फेस इसका एंटीरियर साइड में है तो दूसरा साइड क्या होगा?
पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट होगा एक में हमें एसेसरी पीछे से दिखाई देगी एक में हमें एसेसरी आगे से दिखाई देगी समझ में आया अब चूंकि यहाँ बहुत छोटी छोटी बोन्स प्रेजेंट है मसल्स प्रेजेंट है तो यहाँ पर एक नेटवर्क बनता है दिस नेटवर्क नोन एज एंटीरियर कार्पल रिटेन एंड ऑन द पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट दिस नेटवर्क इज नोन एज posterior carpal radii anterior carpal radii and posterior carpal radii theek hai former interosseous is originate at the level of the proximal इंट्रोशियस स्पेस दिस ब्लड वेसल कॉमन ट्रंक चला आ रहा है यहां से ये कॉमन इंट्रोशियस ब्लड वेसल ओरिजिनेट ठीक है दिस कॉमन इंट्रोशियस आर्टरी इज कंटिन्यूड डिस्टली एंड इट गिव ब्रांच एट एंटीरियर साइड एंड एट पोस्टीरियर साइड एंड इट टेक पार्ट इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंटीरियर कार्पल रेटिन एज वेल एज पोस्टीरियर कार्पल रेटिन ठीक है and the main trunk is continued and it gives a branch to anterior part that known as anterior interosseous artery and also continues as posterior part known as posterior interosseous artery common interosseous artery a common artery originates with divides into anterior and posterior and these blood vessels take part in the formation of the carpal radii anterior carpal and posterior carpal radii clear because this common interosseous artery is also continued distally to take part in the formation of the palmar arch jiske bare mein abhi hum baat karenge ठीक है सो द मेन ब्रांच द कॉमन इंट्रोशियस आर्टरी एंड इट गिव्स ब्रांचेस टू फॉर्म द एंटीरियर कार्पल रेटे एंड पोस्टीरियर कार्पल रेटे एंड ऑल्सो टेक पार्ट गिव एंटीरियर इंट्रोशियस आर्टरी क्लियर इज देयर एनी डाउट क्लियर हुआ इन दिस पिक्चर यू कैन ऑल्सो सी दैट देयर इज एक्सिलरी आर्टरी मेन ब्रांच सब स्कैपुला निकल गई उसके बाद ब्रेकियल बोला ब्रेकियल के बाद डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी आ गई ब्रेकियल से डीप ब्रेकियल आर्टरी आ गई कोलेट्रल अल्नार आ गई ये भी पोस्टीरियर एस्पेक्ट में मिलेगी कोलेट्रल अल्नार एंड एक ब्रांच जो है वो कॉमन इंट्रोशियस आ गई और जो मेन ट्रंक है दैट कंटिन्यू एज द मीडियन आर्टरी ठीक है एंड दिस मीडियन आर्टरी इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट दैट इज द रेडियल आर्टरी एंड द अल्नार आर्टरी जो हम आगे बात करेंगे इतना समझ में आया कि नहीं आया उसके बारे में बताओ कॉमन इंट्रोशियस आर्टरी द मेन ट्रंक इज कंटिन्यू एज अ मीडियन आर्टरी ठीक है एंड मीडियन आर्टरी इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू ब्रांच दैट इज द रेडियल ब्रांच एंड द अल्नार ब्रांच radial artery and the ulnar artery when we reaches distally here you can see that two branches comes radial and ulnar
ulnar continue on the volar aspect, while radial also give a branch to the dorsal aspect. Metacarpal में vascular foramen होते हैं क्या? Vascular groove, vascular foramen ऐसा कुछ पढ़ा है metacarpal में? मेटाकार्पल में वेस्कुलर ग्रूव, वेस्कुलर फोरामेन ऐसा कुछ टर्म पड़ी है? डॉर्सल एस्पेक्ट में, वेंट्रल एस्पेक्ट में? नहीं पड़ा शायद ना?
So when we reaches at this area, the main trunk median artery is further divided into two blood vessels, radial and ulnar. Radial blood vessel and ulnar blood vessel. The radial also gives a branch that passes through the vascular foramen, reaches over the dorsal aspect, and continues as a dorsal metacarpal artery at the area of dorsal region. Branch from radial artery on the dorsal aspect is continue as a dorsal metacarpal artery, and it passes toward the region of digit and continue as dorsal common digital artery. Dorsal common digital artery, and then further dividing into dorsal proper digital artery. So this is the blood supply to dorsal aspect, crosses the vascular foramen, reaches over the dorsal surface, then continue as a dorsal metacarpal artery, dorsal common digital artery, and then proper digital artery. On the volar aspect, on the palmar aspect or on the volar aspect, the radial arteries continue as a median volar metacarpal artery, yeah, volar median metacarpal artery, volar median metacarpal artery, then distally it continues as a volar median digital artery, volar median digital artery. About the course of the radial artery. On the posterior aspect, median artery is divided into radial artery and the ulnar artery. The radial artery give a branch that passes through the dorsal aspect, continuing as the dorsal metacarpal artery, dorsal common distal artery, and proper distal artery. And the remaining portion is continue as a volar median metacarpal artery and volar median distal artery. Okay? Volar median metacarpal artery and volar median distal artery. Clear? So this is about the fate of the radial artery in this in this menis region. Now the ulnar artery. Ulnar artery is continue as volar metacarpal artery or volar common metacarpal artery, then volar common distal artery, volar common distal artery, which further bifurcate to form volar proper distal artery. Volar proper distal artery. The common interosseous artery, after giving branches to form the carpal radii, continue on the lateral aspect distally and form lateral volar distal artery. This one is the common interosseous, which giving branches continue as a caudal interosseous, and then it continue as a volar lateral distal artery or lateral volar distal artery. This is the median artery. Median artery is further divided into radial artery and ulnar artery. Clear? That much is clear. So the dorsal region of the menis area is completely supplied by the branch from the radial artery. Is completely supplied by the branch from the radial artery, from the dorsal metacarpal artery, dorsal common distal artery, proper distal artery. But the volar aspect is supplied by the three blood vessels. Volar aspect is supplied by the three blood vessels, radial artery, ulnar artery, and common interosseous artery. The radial artery is continue as a median distal artery. Common interosseous is continue as a lateral distal artery. And ulnar artery is continue as a volar common distal artery. Clear? Clear? यहाँ किसी को कोई डाउट परेशानी दिक्कत हो तो नहीं समझ में आ रहा हूं तो आई थिंक दैट मच ब्लड सप्लाई टू द लिम्ब ऑफ द कैटल फोर लिम्ब ऑफ द कैटल इज वेरी मच क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू इज देयर एनी डाउट Okay, so that much is about the blood supply of the forelimb. The remaining portion is the nerve supply of the forelimb. That we will discuss in the next class.
Is there any doubt regarding the muscles and blood supply of the forelimb? About the theoretical aspect, because I made a video and it is not transferred yet to the laptop. That's why I am unable to show it. But in next class, I will try to show it. So it will very much clear about the muscles of forelimb area, as well as about the brachial plexus and some portion of the blood vessel. Okay. So that's all for today's class. Thank you very much for your patience listening. Thank you.